sooner or later, you people are gonna figure out I'm like the Doc Brown of micro FPV. 1.21 gigawatts! Ah! Today's an exciting day. Look, I put the little flowery thing on here. I don't know why they call them clover leaves. Clover leaves are flat. This is kind of puffy, like a chrysanthemum, those big puffy things that pop up in, you know, around Easter, chrysanthemums. So after flying around with the whip antenna, I said, you know what? I think I said this in a previous video. I don't want that dipole on there anymore. There's too much interference. I can't really enjoy my flight without some kind of interference happening. So I got this. What is this, you may ask? This is a Furious FPV U.FL antenna cloverleaf, right-handed, whatchamacallit crap. Right-handed, like me. Hey, this is the devil's hand, man. Everyone knows it. So as you can see, with some of the footage from the last time I flew at this park, not very good. A lot of ins and outs on that. A lot of static. Let's put this puppy up and show you the difference. I will include the link for this down below. However, you can get it off of Furious FPV's site. I'm pointing in case you can't see my finger off the side. Furious FPV site, which I'll also link down below. They're a little bit cheaper off of Furious FPV. I really wanted the red one, but they weren't in stock at the time, so I just got the black one. Who cares? The body's black, the red, I'll get a red one soon. I purchased mine off Amazon, not a sponsored video. I'm just pointing it out to you guys in case you want to do the same thing. This thing is 48 millimeters long. It is a perfect fit. The way you get this in is pretty easy. I don't think I have to take this apart to show you, but I have some stuff from another build video I did. You unloosen this, you unloosen and take this top off. You slide the UFL connection down through and position it on the board. This will push down pretty nicely into the area, and then you snap it on, and then Fanny's your uncle and Bob's your aunt. I don't know why I like that saying so much. Something Monty Python stuck in my head or something like that, I guess. I don't know. Let's fly. Just for reference, we're gonna fly around the Hobbit party tree. That's what it looks like, the Hobbit party tree. And we're gonna fly around a couple other places and then bring it back in, and then we'll compare the videos. And then you'll be really happy, I think. Just a quick note of clarification about where we are. Usually, I'm over there and I fly around that tree, and that's closer than where I am right here. And so what I'll do is, in testing the antenna, the drone will fly all the way out here, and the other one will fly all the way over there, if that's not confusing enough for you. But that's what I do. You're welcome. Someday, I'm gonna explain all this stuff to you. But for right now, I got the HM DVR recording my stuff. I'm not really that happy about it right now because you gotta do a lot of rigmarole. Remember rigmarole? You gotta do rigmarole to get it working. I can't get to the menus right now, so I'm stuck in 640 by 480. I'll figure it out. I can distinctly see a whole less interference than I saw 2 days ago. Love it, love it. Now, if I could just get my DVR all figured out. I actually had gotten one of those AGP techs, and I hooked it up, and it worked for like 3 seconds, and then psh, That's going back. At this point in time, I highly recommend that mod. The antenna tucks in very nicely, as you saw before. I think it works very well, better than the dipole, which of course it would. It's right-hand polarized. The dipole has like no polarized, you know, so can't wear sunglasses because sunglasses are cool. Polarized, get it? So funny. That said, from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, somewhere at an undisclosed location, enjoying the beautiful 68 degree weather and a little bit of a breeze, this is the Mighty Thor. See ya!